going to worship Jesus together again. So I need you to get on your feet because we are going to be moving and singing. So come on, get up on your feet and we're going to worship Jesus. Let's do it, Pastor Matt.
Every move I make in you. You make me move, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Every step I take in you. You are my way, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Waves of mercy, waves of grace. Everywhere I look, I see your face. Your love has captured me. Oh my God, this love, how can it be?
All right, on this next part, I need you guys on your feet and you need to be jumping and waving your arms like this. Come on, let's try it. Here we go.
Na, 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 na.
Come on.
Every move I make in you. You make me move, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Every step I take in you. You are my way, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you.
Here we go.
Ooh, ooh. Waves of mercy, waves of grace. Everywhere I look, I see your face. Your love has captured me. Oh my God, this love, how can it be?
Here we go, we're gonna do it again. Come on, get on your feet.
Na, 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 na.
I can't hear you.
Na, 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 na.
One more time, here we go.
Na, 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 na. Na 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 na.
Give it up for Jesus. Woo! All right, you guys, we are going to continue in an attitude of worship. But before we do, let's go ahead and close our eyes and bow our heads and commit this time of worship to Jesus. Lord, we thank you so much that you've given us this awesome opportunity to come together and worship you no matter where we are at. And Lord, as we sing this next song, it's talking about not being afraid, not being slaves to fear, because we are children of God. And Lord, we thank you that we don't have to live in fear. I know that there's crazy things going on in our world, but we can trust in the fact that you are our Father and that you are going to protect us, you're going to lead us, and you're going to guide us. So Jesus, we give you this time of worship. We love you so much. In your holy name, amen. Let's sing this together.
You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies. So Lord, my fears are gone.
Come on, let's sing this out. I'm no longer slave.
I'm no longer a slave to fear.
Who are we? Sing it out.
I am a child of God. 'Cause I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. From my mother's womb, you have chosen me. Your love has called my name, and I've been born again to your family. Your blood flows through my veins, 'cause I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. Sing that out. I'm no longer a slave. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God.
Yes, Jesus, thank you so much for this time of worship. I pray as we open up your word here in just a moment that you will speak to our hearts, that you will remind us today that we are children of the Most High God. We love you, Jesus. We thank you for this time. And all of God's people said, amen. All right, you guys, we're going to open up our Bible. So if you have your Bible in front of you, go ahead and open up to Job chapter 2. If you don't have your Bible, pause this video, go grab it, open it up to Job chapter 2, and then press play. So do you guys remember what we talked about 2 weeks ago? So last week we had that special Easter message, but the week before that we were in Job chapter 1. Do any of you remember what we were talking about? We saw that Satan was actually making an argument to the Lord that Job only loves the Lord and serves him because of all of the nice things that God has given him. He has a nice life. He was, in fact, even the richest person in his whole area. And so Satan thought, if all of this is taken away from Job, that he would turn his back to God. But did Job turn his back to God? No. He didn't turn away when all of those things was taken away, right? We saw that Job was faithful to God even when he lost everything in his life.
That was Job's first test. And in today's lesson, we're gonna be seeing Job face another test. So this is test number two, and we're gonna see if he passes it. So that's where we pick back up. I'm gonna read verses 1-7 of chapter two, then we're gonna pray and we're gonna get right into it. So Job chapter two, verses 1-7 says this. One day, the members of the heavenly court came again to present themselves before the Lord. The accuser, Satan, came with them. "Where have you come from?" the Lord asked Satan. Satan answered to the Lord, "I have been patrolling the earth, watching everything that's going on." Then the Lord asked Satan, "Have you noticed my servant Job? He is the finest man in all of the earth. He is blameless, a man of complete integrity. He fears God and he stays away from evil. And he has maintained his integrity, even though you urged me to harm him without cause." Verse 4 says, Satan replied to the Lord, "Skin for skin. A man will give up everything he has to save his life, but reach out and take away his health and he will surely curse you to his face." Verse 6, "All right, do with him as you please," the Lord said to Satan, "but spare his life." Let's pray, you guys. Jesus, we come before you right now. We ask as we study Job chapter 2, we learn about Job's second test. Lord, I pray that you will open up our hearts. Lord, that you will help us to receive everything that you have for us. Lord, I know that this season is different for us. It's sometimes confusing and we don't understand fully what's going on, but we know that you do. And in the same way, Job didn't understand what was going on, but you knew, Lord, you are in control. And so Lord, help us to learn from Job. Help us to learn from your word. Jesus, we love you. We give you this time in your holy name. All God's people said, amen. So here we see the angels and Satan making their way before the Lord again. This happened 2 weeks ago, right? The angels and Satan, they presented themselves before the Lord, and the Lord and Satan kind of had this conversation. So here we see something very similar take place again. And the Lord asked Satan again. He says, "Where have you been? What have you been doing?" And Satan says, "Well, I've been walking back and forth on the earth, watching what's going on." I know that sounds kind of scary, right? Is Satan walking around the earth watching what's going on? You guys, in 1 Peter 5:8, it says this, "Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walks about like a roaring lion, seeking who he may devour." In other words, Satan is looking all over this world for people that he can deceive, that he can trick. You guys, we must be sober, which means alert, right? Awake. And we must be vigilant, which means watchful. So I'm gonna try something with you guys really quick. When I say alert, you're gonna act like you're sleeping and then you're gonna wake up. And then when I say watchful, you're gonna go like this, like you're watching. You guys wanna try it? Okay, ready? So act like you're sleeping. Alert, wake up, and watchful. Okay, if I ever say those two words during the message, you gotta do those two things. Let's try it one more time. Ready? Act like you're sleeping. Alert, wake up, and watchful. You gotta be watching. You guys, we as Christians must be awake, we must be alert, and we must be watchful, because the enemy is gonna come and he is gonna try and trick us and deceive us and try and get us to do bad things. You guys, we must be aware of that. We must be ready. We have to have our armor on, just like we talked about a couple weeks ago. But something we see here is that God was confident in his servant Job. He was confident that Job was not gonna turn his back to God during this second test. He was confident in him. Is God confident in you today? Confident enough that when difficulties come, when trials come, that you're not gonna turn your back on God? Can you truly believe that today, that God is confident in you? And so here we see Satan, right? He's asking God to allow Job to now face physical trials, meaning some health conditions, right? So we saw that Job lost everything that he has, right? His family, his livelihood, his animals, his servants. And now Satan is saying, well, of course Job isn't gonna turn his back to you. Well, he still has his health, right? He's still healthy. He still has that going for him. So why don't you take that away, Lord? And then Job will turn his back to you. Do you guys think that Job's gonna turn his back on God when maybe he gets some health conditions? What do you think? I don't think so, but why don't we find out? Let's go ahead and continue reading on and find out what happens. So let's go ahead and read verses 7-10. It says, so Satan left the Lord's presence and he struck Job with terrible boils from head to foot. Verse 8 says, Job scraped his skin with pieces of broken pottery as he sat among the ashes. His wife said to him, are you still trying to maintain your integrity? Curse God and die, she said. But Job replied, you talk like a foolish woman. Should we accept only good things from the hand of God and never anything bad? So in all of this, Job said nothing wrong. So here we see Job get kind of a gross disease. He gets boils all over his body. Do you guys know what boils are? They're so gross. They're like these big red bumps that have pus inside. And they're painful. Even if you just had one boil, it would be painful. Imagine Job. He had these all over his head, all over his face, his body, all the way down to his feet. He was so uncomfortable. Some even say that he was so uncomfortable, he couldn't even lay down and get comfortable, right? He was in so much pain. This next part is kind of gross. He took some broken pottery and he started to scrape off his boils to find some relief. Poor Job was facing a really bad health condition, right? He was in pain. He was sick. He was very uncomfortable. You guys, so like I said earlier, Job lost all of his animals, his livelihood, his children, and now he lost his health. Job was in a terrible trial. Job didn't know why. Job didn't understand why this was happening or what was going on. He didn't know that God was confident in him. All that Job knew was what was right in front of him. Right, all he knew was what was going on, right? He lost everything. Now he's sick. Can't you guys relate, right? We don't know what's going on in our life today. We don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. All we know is what's happening today, right? And we have to trust in God. In times of really hard difficulty, like right now, instead of asking, man, how can I get out of this? You know, what can I do to maneuver myself and get out of this? Let's start asking, what can I get out of this? How can the Lord use me today? How can the Lord use me through this difficult trial? You guys, if we open up our hearts and we surrender to Jesus and we ask him, Lord, I don't understand what's going on, but I know you do. Would you please use me during this time? Would you please help me to be your servant? Let's start asking that question. You guys, God is working in our life and we grow so much during these hard times. Our faithfulness to God should not be based off of what we have or what we don't have, right? The health that we do have or the health that we don't have. Our faith should be based off of the fact that Jesus died on the cross for our sins and he rose from the dead and paid the price for us. You guys, faith is obeying God despite our feelings or our circumstances, knowing that he is working out his perfect plan in his perfect way and in his perfect time. To add another hard thing, this story keeps getting crazier. To add another hard thing for Job. So he gets all of these boils all over his body, oh, so gross. But then his wife comes to him and she tells him, she's like, hey, all of these things are happening to you. We've lost everything we have. Why don't you just turn your back on God and curse him? She said that. Can you believe that? Do you think that that's good advice? Of course not. Job then replies to his wife and he says, that is foolish. I'm going to honor God no matter what my circumstances. You guys, severe trouble or trials will either make someone bitter, which means angry or kind of upset at life, or it'll make them better. Job's wife became bitter and Job became better. You guys, it's so important, and this is a great example, that we are so careful with who we let in our lives. There are plenty of people out there who want to tell us what we should and what we shouldn't do. And you need to surround yourself with friends who also love Jesus, who will help guide you and lead you and give you good, godly advice. Right? But we can't rely on them fully, right, to tell us exactly what to do. Right? We got to make our own decisions. We got to follow Jesus. We got to build a solid foundation like Job had for ourselves, right? Our parents or our friends being Christians doesn't make us a Christian, right? We have to accept Jesus in our heart and we ourselves have to live for Jesus. And you know what, you guys? There will come a time where maybe someone in your life tells you to do something that maybe isn't good. Maybe that time has already come. Maybe you could think about a time when you were at school and maybe someone told you to do something that was bad. Maybe something you knew your teacher or your parents wouldn't be happy with, right? It's so important that we have a solid foundation like we talked about a couple weeks ago. So you can stand against those things just like Job did, right? Job knew the truth. Do you guys know the truth today? Do you know what God's word says? Paul says in 1 Thessalonians 5:21, test all things, hold fast to what is good. And then the Bible also says in Psalms 119:11, your word I have hidden in my heart that I might not sin against you. We as Christians are to test everything to God's word, right? So if someone comes in and says, hey, you should do this, or hey, you don't gotta listen to your parents, or hey, why don't you just cheat on this test? Is that what God's word says to do? No, and we know that. Why? Because we read his word and we hide his word in our heart. But the only way that we will know God's word, the only way that we could build a solid foundation like Job had, is if we read God's word and we study it. We spend time with Jesus. And if we do this, right, if we spend time with Jesus reading his word, when those difficult times come, those difficult seasons, or when someone comes in and tells you to do something that is not right, right, you're gonna know, oh, I remember that one time my parents told me this Bible verse. Or I remember listening to Miss B on camera and she told me this verse. You guys, we are to know God's word and to hide it in our heart. Now I know that some of you might be thinking, how am I gonna memorize the whole Bible? That's impossible. It is impossible. You guys, I'm not even anywhere near close to that. But you know what's so amazing? It's that God's word says that when we are in a time of need, that he will supply our needs, right? He will give us what we need. He will bring to remembrance those Bible verses that you guys are learning, right, during our memory verse challenge. He's gonna bring those things up when you need them, right? When you're in a difficult situation. I remember when I was your guys' age and I did memory verse challenges with the church I went to, and I can look back and I can still remember those memory verses. You know why? Because they're hidden in my heart. So I challenge you guys to read God's word, to do that memory verse challenge with us, to know what God's word says, to build a solid foundation on his word. Because difficult times are gonna come, just like the one we're in right now. People who maybe don't love Jesus are gonna come in and they're gonna try and deceive us. Or the enemy is gonna come in and he's gonna try and trick us and lie to us and do things to kind of catch us off guard. But if we know what God's word says, we can stand firm in his promises. We can stand firm in his faithfulness. So you guys, let's be ready. Are you ready, first through fifth graders? Are you ready to stand firm against the challenges that we face? Are you ready to encourage those in your life, maybe even your parents or your siblings or your grandparents when you FaceTime them? Let's know God's word. Let's read it. Let's learn it. So that way we can be better prepared. All right, you guys, I love you. I'm praying for you. Why don't we go ahead and close off with a word of prayer? If you guys want to close your eyes and bow your heads. Jesus, we thank you so much for your word. We thank you, Jesus, that we get to hide it in our heart. And when we are in need, when difficult times come, Lord, you tell us that you're going to bring up those verses to our memory. You're going to help us. You're going to lead us. You're going to guide us. You're not going to just leave us hanging. You're not just going to leave us in the dark by ourselves to figure it out. You're going to help us. You're going to guide us. So Jesus, we thank you. I pray for these first through fifth graders that you will give them the ability to know your word as they read it, as they study it. Jesus, that you will help them to retain those things in difficult times, just like this one. We could lean not on our own understanding, but on your understanding, Jesus. We love you. We commit the rest of this week to you. And all of God's people said, amen. All right, I love you guys. I will see you in the next video. Shout it out, shout it out.